Death Clock, in a press conference, recently announced plans for their first live show since its attack, giving a much-needed boost to the world's economy.
We know that the world is going through a tough time right now economically. We see a lot of businesses scaling down, but not us. We're gonna put on the biggest, most expensive, elaborate live show that's ever been done. Gonna make spending money metal.
Yeah, check it out. We made solid crystal posters, and they're not even for sale.
Tickets are bet double price. There's no recession for metal. The recession is an asshole.
And with the untimely death of their manager, how will Death Clock continue to organize their multi-trillion-dollar business?
We're not hiring a replacement manager. Too soon, Kemosabe. We're taking on all management things.
I am in charge of financial treasuries.
And I'm head of financial business for years.
I'm chief of financial receipts gathering.
And I'm deputy president of financial money.
And I'm in charge of snacks.
Aren't you frightened of mismanaging this man? Charles Loftinson was considered by many a financial genius. What are your credentials?
No, that's my credentials. We know what we're doing, ass.
And with Death Clock in charge of their finances, how will they control their spending? Receipts have been submitted to the media that show billions of dollars squandered on vanity projects. $15 million was spent on Death Clock kitty shades, sunglasses for cats. $20 million was spent on the Super Tits Candy Snake project, which was never completed or defined. And finally, $85.5 million was spent converting 90 acres of land and corn silos into Cool Ranch Dorito dispensers.
Welcome to Death Clock's Dorito Land. And I'd like to remind you all that Dorito Land is not open to the public. It's just for us. Sorry.